Time to welcome the players. First up, from China, the number 5 seeds, Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang.
The defending champions. 3 times they've won this All England title, 2011, 2013, and of course last year as well. Even finalists in 2012, so a 5th consecutive All England final for Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang.
Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting.
Well, a brand new pairing. Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting. For Tang Yuanting, a 2nd consecutive All England final, because a year ago she was beaten by her opponents of today when she was partnering Ma Jin. What a final it was last year. Absolutely incredible badminton. Can she go one better this year? The youngster, Tang Yuanting.
Heads.
This so, of course, with Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting playing their very first tournament together.
Thank you.
We don't really know their form. We know them both as individuals and their quality as women's doubles players. So to the defending champions first, and Wang Xiaoli on the left as we look at him, 25-year-old from Hubei province. Yu Yang is 28, so she'll turn 29 next month, from Liaoning. Don't be misled by that world ranking of 7. They've only played 6 tournaments towards that world ranking. Optimum number, of course, is 10 to get anything like a realistic ranking. So their win-loss record for last year is very impressive indeed. 6 finals from 7 tournaments played, winning 4 of them. The 4 they won were the only 4 Super Series tournaments they played last year. The All England, the Denmark, the China and the French. So 3 of their 4 titles in premier events. So in their quarterfinal, they beat the twin sisters, Luo Ying and Luo Yu, having played sisters actually in the 2nd round from Bulgaria. In the semi-final, they beat the 2012 winners and the World and Olympic champions, Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei. So to the number 8 seeds, Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting. Bao Yixin, just 22 years of age, from Yiyang and Hunan province in southern China. Tang Yuanting from Mangning, 20 years of age, Tang Yuanting. And this, as you can see, their very first tournament together. No world ranking, no career win-loss, but they have won 4 matches to get through to today's final. In the quarterfinal, they defeated the number 4 seeds, Christina Peterson and Camilla Rota-Yule. It went the full distance, but I have to say, they were 19-11 and 20-14 up in that first game, which they eventually lost 26-24. But it was very comfortable in the deciding game, as you can see. So our court officials for this women's doubles final, Paul Buffum of England and Gavin Smith, also of England. Well, of course, with China guaranteed the title here, this will be the 18th title at the All England Women's Doubles Championships, going to China from the last 20 championships. China's dominance in this discipline is unrivaled.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Wang Xiaoli, Yu Yang, China. And on my left, Bao Yixin, Tang Yuanting, China. Yu Yang to serve, to Tang Yuanting. Love all. Play.
So the defending champions, the far side of the court, Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang.
One love.
Oh, service fault called on Yu Yang.
One ball.
Struck above the waist, says the service judge. Oh, here we go. She's going to tuck her shirt into her shorts so that it's easier for the service judge to see where the waistline is. That's a little bit cheeky, isn't it? Well, of course, in my day, we always had our shirts in our shorts or skirts.
Yeah, but if that service is to be legal, she needs to pull up her shorts a little bit more.
2-1.
Good play from Bao Yixin.
2-2.
Had the most incredible 2013, did Bao Yixin. Reached 9 finals, winning 8 titles with 4 different partners. But Steen, I want your opinion. Do you think this is the partnership for the Olympic campaign, Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting?
I think it's a little bit hard to say. I agree with you that the match where they played 3 games against the Danes, Pedersen and Rudiul was virtually 2 games, because I'm pretty convinced that if they'd won the first game, they would have won the second as well. So they've been doing really, really well here, but the Chinese team is so fortunate that they have a lot of women's doubles players to choose from. That would, in my opinion, mean that Tianqing and Jiayunlei would not go to the Olympics.
3-4.
The defending champions.
And that would be a little bit harsh. I definitely think Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang are one of the 2 best pairs in the Chinese team. Perhaps the best pair, but definitely between the 2 best.
4-3.
But this girl here in the picture, Tang Yuanting, very, very powerful, especially from above tape.
Yeah, and I thought last year in the All England final when she was playing with Ma Jin, she was actually the best player on court.
I totally agree. I just had the same thought.
Yeah.
5-3.
And that might be the reason of partnering her with Bao Yixin. Bao Yixin and Tang Jinhua has been struggling lately, and I think that Ma Jin perhaps was too much of a front court player. As we mentioned earlier in this tournament, one of the things in ladies doubles is that you can easily have a preferred front court player and preferred back court player, but both players need to function well in the opposite positions, because you simply will be out of your favorite position a lot in women's doubles.
Yeah. A lovely interception from Bao Yixin.
7-3.
Now I can remember when I first saw her, Bao Yixin. The umpire is saying not so much celebration, showing your fist to your opponent. I'm not quite sure, but certainly the first time I saw Bao Yixin and I saw her reading of the game at the front of the court, and she had this uncanny ability to just be in the right place at the right time. And when I first saw her play, she was still a teenager. And normally, I think in doubles, it takes a little bit of time, a little bit of experience to really get that feeling and that knowledge of where to stand and when to go for things at the front. But she seemed to have it just a natural ability.
Return possibilities the opponent has when they're put on pressure. It's so rare, and the players that have it have a big chance of succeeding in that.
Yeah, there we are again. That's a lovely example.
So it's over 9-4.
Good return of serve, and look how she just pounced on that, ready and waiting.
Service over, 5-9.
Well put away by Yu Young. Service hold called.
Service over. 10.
Struck above the waist. Well, this is actually Yu Young's eighth All England final in 8 years. Now let's have a look. Oh yeah, good spot. Service judge.
Almost horizontal left arm.
Yeah.
Means that she could in no way have hit it below the lowest rib.
Good interception again from Bao Yixin, but Tang Yuanting doing the setup by smashing in the right place. Only 6 minutes of play to the mid-game interval. Now, of course, no Chinese coaching staff involved because two Chinese pairs playing against each other. So the players left to their own devices. Now, Steen, this is the 13th all-Chinese women's doubles final that we've had over the last 15 championships. And, of course, we know that China
seconds.
Are very, very strong in the women's doubles. So I'm going to ask the million-dollar question. Why?
I think they practice more and better than the rest of the world. And I think sometimes also
11-5.
The rest of the world get a little bit disheartened because they're so good. It seems like such a steep task, tall task, to compete with the Chinese. And in some way, they're right. But of course, it can be done.
So
you just have to
six,
put a lot of hard
11.
Work into it and a lot of correct work into it.
Yeah. Apologises for the neck cord. Yes, good placement of the smash from Bao Yixin.
12-6.
Team who actually won 12. A Super Series title last year playing with one of her opponents, Yu Young. They won the India Super Series. There's been actually seen quite a lot of experimentation with switching the pairs round and changing partnerships in the women's doubles from China over the last 12 months or so.
Yeah, and it's a good idea because, of course, you want to find the two pairs that you want to participate in the Olympics in the two pairs allowed.
Eight,
here we had,
12.
I guess, five Chinese women's doubles pairings in the tournament, but the quota for the Olympics only two, so important to figure out which one are the most competitive. Level, and as we've discussed as well,
12.
A lot of development has taken place. It's not this clearing game, clear and drop game. And
no, both these Chinese players quite obviously want to get on the attack, want to involve the net player.
Bao.
Now, what was Paul Buffon, the umpire, warning Bao against there? Is she still looking at her opponent when she's raising her fist in celebration, and therefore it's seen as intimidation?
I don't know, but it's very interesting, because normally when we see players from the same country play each other, there's not a whole lot of shouting going on, because they know they have to play each other and practice together. But here we have some tension, and I actually think it's great.
Yeah, me too.
So it's over. 14-10.
From Bao Yixin, that block 15, shot 10. Off the body. Well, you know, when I saw the entries for the All England team, and I saw that China had put Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting together for the first time, and I actually sort of thought, oh, I'm really looking forward to seeing them play together as a pair.
You haven't been disappointed, have you?
No, not at all.
In terms of composition, you could say that the combination 10. With Bao and Tang are a bit more clear positions. Bao at the net, Tang at the backcourt, whereas Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang are both great backcourt players. If there were to be a frontcourt player, I think Wang Xiaoli is a little bit better at intercepting
11,
at the
16.
Net. But, very equal in strength, because Wang Xiaoli also hits a very, very hard smash. I believe it's the hardest smash on the women's tour.
Yeah. Oh, that's brilliant. That is the sort of instinctive play, the awareness. And I don't know, Steen, is that something that you
11.
Feel as a coach you can teach a player, or are you reliant on instinctive?
It's much easier to develop a player who already has this instinct from childhood. I mean, at some point it's probably grown, that you sort of read the game a little bit quicker or faster than the other players. But you can teach it, but it requires a lot of practice, a lot of direction, and a lot of video watching. Mm. We'll probably see that Bao Yixin is the one who makes the most creative shots, the turnaround in the defense, the challenges at the net.
18-11.
So just 3 points away from this opening game.
And Bao and Tang, they chose to start on this side of the court, so they probably feel that they go to the good side after the interval between the games.
Well, I'm getting more and more convinced every time I see them play, and it's only the 4 days of these All England Championships, but I'm convinced this is going to be the second Chinese pair for the Olympic campaign. Look at that. Use of the mid-court area. Delightful skill.
20, game point 11.
Whole host of game point opportunities.
That's well played. That's what I would do if I were 12, coaching blue 20. Team here. Get Bao Yixin to work, get her to the baseline. She's not bad at the baseline, but I'd rather have her there than hovering around at the net.
Ow! 13-20.
Trying to see if I were able to put some kind of physical pressure on her.
That's well taken.
14.
Up with a good 20. Low serve from Wang Xiaoli. Great return of serve. And the opening game for the brand new partnership, the youngsters, Bao Yixin.
First
and
game won
Tang
by Bao Yixin, Tang
Yuanting.
21-14
in 17 minutes. And my goodness, the youngsters are gelling well. With other partners as well. Obviously, Ali was world number one with margin. Yu Yang with Olympic gold winning partnership with Du Jing. Just to put into perspective what's happened in that opening game
seconds,
with the youngsters.
20 seconds.
Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting. They're playing against a pair, Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang, who have not only been world champions, world number ones. This, for Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang, is their 36th final from only 43 tournaments played. That is staggering.
Level play.
simply brilliant.
1-love.
Former world junior champion, of course, Bao Yixin, back in 2010. Won the women's doubles at those junior world championships and the mixed doubles. Two gold medals in the same year.
Who did your partner in women's doubles back then?
Yu Dong Ni.
Yeah, because I was thinking about her, and she actually...
So it's over.
She isn't as physical strong as the players we've seen on court here, but I also think that she has an excellent eye for the game.
Yeah. From Tang Yuanting.
So it's over.
We talked about the net skills, the front court skills of Bao Yixin. But
look at that.
Definitely her partner can do that as well, and she's so quick on her feet. And that makes her really, really dangerous. Not necessarily from the front court, but more coming from the back court towards the mid court and continuing the attack.
So it's over. 2-2.
Tang Yuanting speaks some good English. I've had the pleasure of chatting to her on a couple of occasions.
Yeah. 3-2.
Took that early, didn't she?
Yeah, the mid-court skills.
3-4.
Just around the tape, they're excellent with Tang Yuanting. Such a quick mover, both sideways and back and forwards.
Fire! 4-3.
Rest of the Chinese team. Watching.
Oh, look at that.
There it was again. Faster comes from one side of the court to the other.
Yeah. 5-3.
Xiao Yunlei has won the mixed doubles earlier today. I think her place in the women's doubles set up may be in doubt. Oh, round the back there from Yu Yang.
6-3.
And the two-time world champions, Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang, are in a spot of bother here. Look at that, trying the trickery.
Are giving them a hard time in practice as well.
Yeah. Yeah, and just look at the body language of the former world champions and defending champions here.
Hey! 7-7. 4-7.
Confidence on her serve as Yu Yang, having been called a fault twice in the opening game.
That was a fault as well. in my opinion.
Yeah, but not called. Of course, she's also won the All England Mixed Doubles title with her Han Bin back in 2009. She apologises, but I wouldn't apologise. That was a brilliant play.
I'm wondering what level of ladies' singles she actually can play in at the moment, Tang Yuanting. She's really, really quick.
Thank you. 9-4. Play. Service over. 5-9.
Oh, hey. It's gone long.
6-9.
From Wang Xiaoli.
7-9.
Terrific. Oh, the pace of this women's doubles.
It's
just extraordinary.
And every time Wang and Yu are a little bit out of balance, they're punished. They simply can't afford to be caught off balance. And I think they have to play a little bit more soft shots. It seems like they can't be the two youngsters on pace.
Yeah, great defense. Look at that. Look at that.
11-8 interval.
It's really not just getting the shuttle back. They are so creative with their defensive play. Looked to be in trouble, but still found the gap. So 11-8, the advantage in the second game, having already won the first. Steen, I remember the first year that the Premier Super Series came into existence, 2011. This pair of
players,
now
Xiaoli
and Yu Young, won all five Premier titles. They were almost unbeatable.
Yeah, they were unbeatable virtually until 2012. They only lost one match to a non-Chinese pair at that time, and that was a Korean pair.
Yep.
I think they've lost one or two matches against fellow Chinese pairings, but
11-8.
Two or three matches altogether.
Play.
That's a fantastic record. Not quite as impressive anymore, but still very, very good.
Play.
Yeah, and to be ranked number 7 in the world, with only 6 tournaments counting towards your world ranking. Missed it.
And she's got so much power from the baseline, Tang Yuanting. So Bao Yixin gets really, really good chances, good opportunities to work with on the front court.
You know, I do like the way that China has developed these two youngsters as players, Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting. Both have had the opportunities to play with more experienced players, bring them on. Playing with the likes of Ma Jin, Tian Qing, and even Yu Yang. Good challenge here. Yep. Oh no. Maybe she was just showing her disappointment.
Nine.
I thought she was going to challenge. I was getting all excited. No, oh. That was clearly a good call, line judge. Of the perspiration.
Thank you. Thank you.
One of the things that has been troublesome for the other pairs in the women's doubles circuit when they're meeting Yu Yang and Wang Xiaoli is their physicality. Doesn't seem like they can use it in the same way here. Being put under pressure by the play by the
14,
two young Chinese players.
Nine.
Bao and Tang.
Oh. Oh, she made, well, she taps her head as if to say, well, how on
earth
did you miss that? But
10, 14.
Well, she may have missed Steen, but I like the fact that she was looking for it.
Yeah, she was able to read it.
Yeah.
The swing was a little bit too big, but you read it all right.
Oh, terrible indecision for Yu Yang at the back of the court.
15, 10.
The time running out for the defending champions.
So it's over. 11-15.
Once again,
so
and the defense
over.
Of Tang Yuanting.
11.
That is extraordinary.
And sometimes when players from the same nation play each other, we hear and read these theories that the result might be in some way given.
Yeah,
I'm
but
I'm really happy to say that this is definitely not the case here.
No, and the youngsters are playing as if, and this is probably going to sound wrong, but as if they've got no respect for their opponents. They're saying, we know we can match you.
Yeah.
We're taking the match to you. We're going to be aggressive. We're going to get on top of the rallies from the start. And that's a really good attitude. I like that.
They're saying, you've been great, but now it's our turn.
Yeah.
Service over. 12-17.
Got in each other's way. What a rally. Got to be the longest rally of the match so far.
Well played by Yang and Wang Xiaoli. Challenging Bao Yixin.
13.
Can beat us from the back court as well. Two Chinese girls discussing what are we going to do if Wang and you continue to put pressure on Bao Yixin at the backcourt. How do we get things turned around and get her back to the front court?
Annoyed.
So it's over. 18-13.
Well, as I say, when I heard they were going to be playing together, I thought they would have huge potential. I didn't think they'd be realising that potential quite so quickly. And apart from that previous rally, when they got in each other's way, they look as if they've been playing together for years. They've got a good rotational movement on court.
I suppose they have a lot of sort of systems that they run on all their
19,
double pairings,
13.
So it's easy to switch them around.
Yeah. 2 points away from the title in their first ever tournament together. Oh, that's a nice return of serve.
So it's over. 14-19.
Turn of the lucky net cord.
20
and
match point
six
14.
Match point opportunities for Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting.
Game.
This is incredible. What a way to start your partnership. Winning the All England title. Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting. A little
match
under 40
Yixin,
minutes of play.
21-14, 21-14.
Symmetry in the scoreline, 14 and 14. And I really didn't think it would be as comfortable as that. I did think, having seen Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting earlier in the tournament, that they could certainly push their opponents the full distance. They did more than push their opponents the full distance. They destroyed them in today's final. Defensively, they were great. Attacking-wise, they penetrated with the attack time and time again. And Bao Yixin's reading of the game from the front of the court was absolutely superb. Well, I thought it would be a partnership for the future. It's a partnership for the now. No wonder they're happy. What a result for the youngsters. Let's hear what they have to say with Howard Benson.
I think All England, it's a very important tournament for me because of the tradition here, the history, and also all the opponents are very tough. So for me, this is a very important tournament.
Let's just talk about the opponents. Is it harder when you're playing a pair from China and a pairing you know very, very well?
当你们的对手是你们自己的队友，也是你们好的朋友的时候，会不会更困难一些呢？ 我觉得因为对手是拿过很多世界大赛的冠军，我觉得我们心态会比较好吧，就是拼对手，然后就向对手学习。 I think our opponent, because they have won many, many titles before, and for us, we came into this match with a great mentality. We have nothing to lose and really just learning from the opponent.
And what would you like to say to the fabulous Chinese fans in the crowd here at the Barclaycard Arena?
你们对现场这些很棒的中国球迷们有什么话想说的吗？
我觉得 I stand here to say something to yours and thanks for your support.
Wonderful.
We didn't need the translation skills of Angela that time. The Women's Doubles Champions 2015, Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting.
Well, I told you she could speak some good English. I think that is probably the first time I've heard Chinese players doing part of their interview in English after victory in one of these major Super Series tournament finals. Well done, Tang Yuanting, and also, of course, to her partner, Bao Yixin. Just about ready for the prize presentation for the women's doubles.
Ladies and gentlemen, time for the presentation for the women's doubles final. Please show your appreciation to our presentation party. Shuichi Yoniyama, Executive Managing Director of Yonex Europe. Dominic Grinston, Managing Director of MetLife UK. And Councillor Shafiq Shah, Lord Mayor of Birmingham. First presentation goes to our officials, umpire Paul Buffum and service judge Gavin Smith, both from England, receiving their commemorative medals.
All our court officials volunteer their time and they do a wonderful job.
Let's hear it for the runners-up in the women's doubles from China, Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yan.
So the three-time former champions of the All England this year have to settle for second best. Today was their fifth consecutive women's doubles final at these prestigious championships.
Receiving their runners-up medals and commemorative Snoopies from Dominic Grinstead. And let's hear it. Ladies and gentlemen, for the winners of the women's doubles from China, Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting.
A star partnership has been born. Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting in their very, very first tournament together win the Yonex All England title. For Tang Yuanting, receiving her medal now. She was a beaten finalist last year. This year, she's gone one better with Bao Yixin.
And now, Shuichi Yoniyama, Executive Managing Director of Yonex Europe, hands over the coveted trophies. Ladies and gentlemen, the Yonex All England Open Badminton Championships, women's doubles winners from China, Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting.
Worthy champions.
Many thanks to our presentation party.
And the players will do a lap of honour.
Photo opportunities now.
A couple of photos for the winners.
For our champions. And do join us for our runners-up, our champions, on their lap of honour around the Barclaycard Arena.
Steen, China may be dominant in the women's doubles discipline, but I think this is a pair that could take women's doubles to a whole new level.
I totally agree. I was just thinking the same thing. Seems like they're very, very happy for their win and open and ready to be stars.
Yes, I particularly like their whole attitude, their style of play. Despite undoubted qualities in defence, actually determined to attack, and that aggressive attacking style really is so good to watch. Obviously, absolutely delighted. The big smiles from Bao Yixin and Tang Yuanting. Now, what a way to start your partnership. You can't get much better than that. All England champions.
Girls, well done.
How lovely to see such delight from the women's doubles winners. We turn our attention now to our last final of the afternoon. It's men's doubles, the number two seeds, Matthias Bo and Carsten Mogensen, up against Fu Haifeng and Zhang Nan of China. Let's join our MC to get the players onto court.
Time to welcome the players. Let's hear it for the first pair from China, Fu Haifeng and Zhang Nan.
For both Chinese players walking onto court, this is a fifth All England final. Of course, for Zhang Nan, it's the second final of the day. For this man, the left-handed Fu Haifeng, four times he was a finalist in the men's doubles with Kai Yun, having won the title on two occasions, 2005 and 2009.
And give it up for their opponents, the number two seeds from Denmark, Matthias Bo and Carsten Mogensen.
The former champions, Matthias Bo and Carsten Mogensen, winners of the All England title in 2011, having been beaten finalists the year prior to winning the title. So this, for the Danes, a third All England final appearance.